The reservoir is used for transported to the back of the elevator by the frequency feeder. At the back of the elevator elevates the bran to the temporary storage tank. The reservoir is reached by the dosing scale after it is taken out from the temporary storage tank, and the accurate processing weight is recorded. After that, the bran is transported to the cleaning cradle by the feeder to take out the impurities. Clean bran is transported to the roller magnetic selector by the back of the elevator to remove iron tramp. Then it is sent to the double-deck material distributing scraper and distribute the bran to the flour product separation sieve. There are layers of different mesh griddles. The griddles make circling motion, broken rise, fine broken rise. And the bran were separated by different mesh griddles, and they were sent to the temporary storage tank by the collection scraper. Clean bran sent to the tempering pot by the clean bran collector scraper. The rice bran tempering pot is multi-layer structure. The trim spread from the bottom inner layer to softened bran. Softened bran is sent to the embedded scraper conveyor, elevated to the extruder feeding auger. The feeding auger sent the bran equally to the extruder. High pressure stage caused by the screw extrusion cutting from the bran, and it is sprayed out from the discharge hose and turned to power stage, which will be helpful for the solvent extraction. Expanded bran drops into the counter current dryer and sent to the first floor. There is a material uniform distribution device inside the counter current dryer. The moisture is taken off by hot wind to achieve the best extraction temperature and moisture. The expanded bran then transported to the extraction plant by the horizontal scraper conveyor. Pre-treatment materials will be sent to the sealed spiral conveyor by horizontal scraper conveyor by horizontal sealed screw conveyor. The material needed to be extracted will be sent into the material storage tank through conveyor. While there has a rigid material level control system inside the material storage tank, the rigid material level control system controls rotor size, tractor frequency, motor speed. And ready to extract the material will be arranged in the reorganization. The rotor cell structure interior designs material level, adjusting an anti-penetration device. The material runs a circumference and then discharged through the outlet. The wet meal will be elevated into the wet meal sealed screw conveyor. And the sealed screw conveyor will send the wet meal into DTDC desolventizer, where the DTDC desolventizer is controlling by pre-desolventing layer, desolventing layer, drying layer, cooling layer. Each layer designs automatic material level control. The material meal will be discharged into the meal discharging scraper conveyor, and the discharged material meal will be elevated into meal library. High purity solvent is sprayed into the lube extractor by the first stage spray system. Sprayed material enter into the drip dry section of the extractor. The low concentrated mixed oil in the bottom of the first frame bag bin of it is pumped by number 1 solvent pump and is sprayed to the top of material in the second frame bag bin and so on. Low concentration mixed oil is sprayed circularly. The oil concentration of the solvent decreases and the mixed oil purity increased. High concentration mixed oil from the bottom of the second frame, which on the top of the lube extractor. Pumped into the mixed oil centrifuge. Go into the fixed oil continuous filter after removing the big impurities. Go into mixed oil temporary storage tank after removing little impurity of oil. The mixed oil extracted by extraction pump, which goes through crude oil counter. and transport it to the pre-evaporator, which is heated by the solvent gas heat from the DTDC. The mixed oil presents rising film state. When it goes through the stainless steel tubes, the solvent gas is separated by the vapor-liquid separation at the top of the pre-evaporator. After first time concentration, the mixed oil goes into the temporary storage tank. The number one evaporator extraction pump sends the mixed oil to the heat exchanger. After that, the oil is sent to the number 2 evaporator. This evaporator is heated by indirect steam. The mixed oil presents rising film state. When it goes through the stainless steel tubes, the solvent gas is separated by the vapor-liquid separator on the top of the number 2 evaporator. After second time concentration, the mixed oil goes into the temporary storage tank and then is pumped to the steam dripping chamber by the number 2 evaporator extraction pump. Through a disc shunt inside the steam tripper chamber, the mixed oil forms thin films on the stainless steel disc, and the extracted crude oil is further concentrated to achieve the state standard. The extracted crude oil from the steam tripping chamber is conveyed to the oil-oil heat exchanger at the steam tripping extraction pump. After the heat exchange, it is sent to the crude oil temporary storage tank. The meal from the extraction plant is sent to the packaging scale by the horizontal scraper conveyor and packed. The extracted crude oil goes into the refining plant and temporary storage into the crude oil tank. The crude oil pump pumps the oil into the crude oil filter. Filtered oil goes into the energy-saving heat exchanger. Dry oil and the crude oil exchange the heat, then sent to the crude oil heater. After temperature rise, the crude oil goes into the oil-acid mixture. Ratio merit phosphoric acid inside the mixture intensively mix with oil. Acid refining oil goes into the acidification tank to have a delayed acid refining reaction. After the reaction, the oil goes into the lime mixture that intensively mix with ratio merit alkali liquid. Mixed oil goes into the alkali refining reaction tank to have delayed reaction. The alkali refined oil is sent to the alkali oil heater by the pump. After temperature rise, the oil is sent to the degumming centrifuge. By high-speed centrifugal separation, the soap is separated from the alkali refined oil and recycled by the inquiry tank on the first floor. The alkali refined oil comes into the oil-water mixture after intensive mix with ratio merit water. The oil entered the dehydration centrifuge. With a high-speed centrifugal force, the soap water is separated and sent to the comprehensive water knockout tank to be processed. The oil enters the dry oil heater. After heated, goes to the vacuum dryer. The vacuum dryer machine with vacuum system. The moisture inside the oil is rapidly removed and dried. The oil after dehydration is pumped into the dry oil tank for temporary storage. The transport pump conveys the oil to oil-oil heat exchanger. To exchange heat with the devaxing liquid oil, after that, the oil enters the crystallization and maturing tank. The devaxing crystallization and maturing tank is a vertical structure with a stainless steel snake tube inside to lower the temperature, matching with the PLC cooling curve to ensure the crystallization achieves the best effect. The crystallized oil is conveyed to the diaphragm filter by the screw filter pump. The wax oil through membrane filtered and then side pressed, so the wax separated from the filter with the automatic cooling plate open, and is transported to the second floor wax oil tank for temporary storage. Then it is conveyed to the oil-oil plate heat exchanger by the devaxing oil pump to exchange the heat with the dry oil. After that, the oil be sent to the oil heat exchanger to exchange heat with the deodorization oil, and then goes into the de-waxing oil heater to get oil heated and temperaturized. The decolorization clay is transported to the temporary storage tank by the pneumatic system. The clay will be added to the pre-mixed tank after it was measured by clay dosing system. The clay and oil are fully mixed in the pre-mixed tank with the vacuum stage. Mixed oil enters the decolorization tower. The tower matching with vacuum system, dumps up powered structure. Dry steam stirring, mix the clay and oil fully mixed. The mixed decolorization oil is transported to the blade vibration filter by decolorization oil pump. The blade vibration filter internal, dumps stainless steel 304 mesh. The decolorization oil passes through the stainer and exported, but the oil can do it. After that, the compressed gas explodes to dry the clay. Then the discharge valve in the bottom of the filter will be opened to discharge the waste clay to the temporary room on the first floor. Decolorization oil goes into the back filter to get the secondary filter. Filtered oil goes into the gas cylinder to remove the air in vacuum state. Then the gas extraction pump conveys the oil to two oil heater exchanger to exchange heat with the deodorization oil.
After that, the oil will be sent to the conduction oil heater to exchange heat with high temperature oil, and then enters the physical deacidification shower.
After the deacidification oil enters the shower, the gray separator equally separates the oil, and the oil drops into the correct heat packing. The oil forms thin film on the packing. Fatty acid vaporization inside the shower. The fatty acid gas extracted by the vacuum system and sent to the condenser for condensation recovery. The deacidification oil is conveyed to the conduction oil heater, the oil extraction pump, to get secondary heating, and then transported to the physical deacidification in the deodorization shower. The physical deacidification and deodorization shower structure combines deacidification shower and deodorization shower. After the secondary deacidification on the top, the oil flows to the deodorization shower and the bottom. The main mount pump ejector design inside the deodorization promotes the oil in the steam fully contact to separate the light constituent gas from the oil in the high vacuum system. The deodorization oil is thrice transported to the oil screw plate heat exchanger, the extraction pump, to exchange heat. After heat exchanging, the oil enters oil plate heat exchanger, and finally comes into the oil water cooler. After polishing by the polishing filter, the cooled deodorization oil enters the deodorization oil temporary storage tank. The deodorization finished oil is pumped into the degreasing crystallization tank by the finished oil pump. After crystallization, the fatty oil is sent to the thermal discharge filter by degreasing filter pump. The thermal discharge filter separates the stearin from the oil. Degreasing oil is transported to the finished oil temporary storage tank, then is pumped to the product oil tank area or filling plant. The fatty acid gas from the acidification shower and the acidification deodorization shower is conveyed to the fatty acid catcher. After centrifugal separation, the fatty acid liquid from the fatty acid recovery system straight to the fatty acid gas. Fatty acid liquid is recovered to the temporary storage tank. Through the fatty acid pump, it is sent to the outdoor fatty acid tank. Back oil in the tank area will be filled after merit by the oil discharge system. Product oil is packed by the filling machine to the bottles. Automation control room is set inside the plant area. The production line controlled by PLC system to finish production.